We're here in Berlin at the Block Show Europe, and we're here with a very interesting guy from Argentina. Could you please introduce yourself?
I'm Rodolfo Andrañez. I'm from the Argentinian Bitcoin NGO and Latin American Bitcoin NGO, and founder of the Latin American Bitcoin and Blockchain Conferences.
Wow. I think cryptocurrency and Bitcoin, of course, must be quite big in Argentina, Latin American countries, Venezuela, of course.
Well, you have some countries in which it's not big as a technology, but it's big as a currency. Mm-hmm. Yes, Colombia, Venezuela. Brazil does a lot of trading and uses the crypto itself. And then you have countries like Argentina that crypto is relevant, but you have lots of developers and more blockchain solutions on top of crypto rather than crypto trading.
Okay. And you're full-time, busy with the whole crypto space. And how big is it actually in Argentina and Latin America?
Argentina, you have around 200,000 users, yes.
Investors.
Then in Brazil, you have almost around 800,000 users.
Yeah.
Colombia moves a nice amount of cash, not such big amounts of users, but a big amount of stash of cash. And now we are doing our next conference in Chile, not because of being big, but because we try to do the conferences in the places where we think it's needed to create bigger communities and stuff like that. So we promote the adoption of, I'm full-time promoting adoption of cryptocurrencies in government and businesses and the grassroots.
Wow.
But our conference, we try to move them to the places where we want to promote more actively adoption. So in this case, it will be Chile.
Yeah, and also Chile is quite interesting. It's most of the more economically
it's one of the most economically stable places, and actually it's one of the less unbanked spaces. So it's interesting to get them into grasp what's the disruption, because sometimes some countries, they feel that they are already settled, that we all have banks and we all do this in. We already have solutions well suited, but they don't understand how blockchain can change things that they actually feel that are good enough. Mm. Yes, we want to show them the disruption that this could bring also to those who already have bank solutions and stuff like that.
Okay, sounds good. And actually, what does your daily business look like? Because actually you was one of the pioneers also in Bitcoin. Eh? You had this domain, bitcoins.com.
Yeah, since 1997.
Wow.
Yeah, I traded the domain to Mark Arpeles, MTGOX. So it's one of the assets of MTGOX now.
Oh yeah, okay.
Yes.
For some Bitcoins.
Eventually. and fiat too. Mm. I'm in this since then. Actually, I'm sort of grateful of what happened to me back then, and I've been giving back since then. So I created this. I and a team of me created these NGOs, and my daily stuff is working on different kind of projects. We're launching this Friday one which is called La Bitcoineta, which is a van or a caravan that will go around Argentina and Latin America, doing grassroots approach and understanding real situations from small communities of what kind of benefits blockchain could bring, trying to raise those stories and to bring solutions to those stories. We have a project with the Inter-American Development Bank, which is like the World Bank but for Latin America, which is for giving digital ID and land registry and educational registry to unbanked and low-level income citizens.
Do you know how big the group of unbanked is in Latin America? I mean, it's hard to say.
Depends some countries. You have countries with almost 70%, which is tremendous. think Ecuador or places like that. And then you have countries with 40%. I think Argentina is around 40. I mean, it depends. I would say it's between the first places with unbanked as regions, you know? I mean, I guess Africa, Latin America, then other countries. But I Latin America, it's, if you just think about the unbanked, you would feel, oh, no, but so everybody's poor. No, actually, no. I mean, you have a huge amount of high-level...
Brazil, Argentina.
Brazil, Argentina, Mexico. I mean, Chile also. It's not that everybody is unbanked, but you have a... You have like these two good things: high tech, high knowledge, high education. But you also have this: if you want to do more a social impact or approach, you have also much work to do. We are hosting like from since we are doing La BitConf, we are also hosting a project which is called Blockchain for Humanity, which is all startups related to social impact, because we have this main focus in social impact solutions, and that's what we try to do.
Sounds very good. To conclude, are you a trader yourself or more a hodler?
Actually, I'm absolutely not a trader. No. Yes, I care not much about the price. I care more about the technology and about impact. Helping others to understand. Actually helping others to get rich also. I don't care. I just want them to understand what's this all about. And if I could, just for closing, I inviting anybody who wants to come to meet Latin American communities and to understand the opportunities that can be achieved there, to join us 5, 6, 7, and 8 of December in La BitConf. Yes, the Latin American Bitcoin and Blockchain Conference. It's the most relevant conference in Latin America.
Where is it?
It's this year. It will be in Chile.
Wow.
In Chile. Yes.
We should go there. Chile, Latin America. The dates?
5, 6, 7, and 8 of December.
Wow. We should go there for
vacations.
For Dutch Sinterklaas, we go to Latin America. Thank you very much for your talk, and all the best with all the projects. Thank you. Very nice.